sweet of you. I hope your day is going well. Hakuna Matata! Welcome back. Let's play some more Banjo-Kazooie on the N64. Not emulated, my console's right next to me. What was I doing? Well, I think we got done with Bubblegum Swamp. So I believe we can just continue on. I don't even think I got Gobi's Desert unlocked. Go in there. Yeah, so it's mainly just walking around Gruntilda's lair for a little while. That's how you get the Bubble Glitch Swamp jiggy. Option is to go over here to the left. For these webs right here, use eggs. Usually takes three. One shortcut has been activated. Oh, do you want to know something interesting? Destroy this honey nest or honey pot, whatever we call it, and you get some health, the bees will attack you, right? But if you use the gold feathers, you'll be able to fight off the bees. You can actually kill off the bees. Let's try to go up here. Can't really see the number yet. 350, huh? Yeah, we can open that. Gruntilda's sister is over there. Mad Monster Mansion. Is there anything I can do with that? I don't believe so. I don't believe there's anything I can do here yet. I don't think I got Mad Monster Mansion opened up. Careful about the ledge. The light kind of dims and lights up when you're in here. So it's kind of hard to tell where the ledge is. You know, I'm not going to remember any of these. And I'm not writing them down like I used to, so... that's going to be trouble. Oh no! Oh no! Let's not do that anymore. Frizzizi Peak, but the thing is, between Gobi's Valley and Frizzizi Peak, they actually require both of each other's moves. Like, Bottles is inside Gobi's Valley and in Frizzizi Peak. He teaches one move that the other world uses. It's best to just go to one world. It's best to go to one world, learn one move, then go to the other world. So if you intend to go to Frizzizi's Peak, go to Gobi's Valley first, learn that move, then go back to Frizzizi Peak. That's how you get a jiggy later on, but you'll see. Anywho. I need to get more notes, don't I? Woo! let's go to Gobi's Valley first. I'm not worried about the sand. That's why I'm not worried about the sand, because she'll refill your health. And also, it's just one health, so... Oops. Sorry about cutting you off, Grinchelda. And that's a for ZZ Peak move right there. The speed boots. It froze. Oh my god. Oh my god, that was the first time it ever froze. Well, you know what they say, blow on your cartridge. Because it removes all the dust. I'm joking, it puts moisture into it. Which is not good. You're not supposed to blow on your cartridge. Good grief. Well, a surefire way to see if it's saved or not. Well, one way is to see whether or not it created the shortcut. If it created the shortcut, then it should be okay that, you know, for that. Okay, so that was created. So I didn't lose all my data. Like a jerk. You know, that's the first time that game ever froze on me. I'm actually kind of interested about that. Let's see if it happens again. Nope, they didn't freeze. That was strange. That monster is called a grabba. Because it tries to grab you. Har-har. That's a scare. I'm trying to think, where is Boss? Oh, I remember where he is. He's right over here. Oh, Now let's get out of here. The problem with Gobi's Valley is if you don't learn the skill that Bottles gives you, you cannot get 100 notes. You will be short 8 notes because you will not have the ability from Frizzy's Peak. So you will have gone through all that trouble only to have the notes reset on you. This is if you're playing the N64 version. Because the notes reset every time you come out of the level. So it's kind of like, it's a bit trollish, because it's like, if you don't have the skill, you're not going to get 100. But hey, go ahead, try to get the 100. Oh, you can't get it? Oh well. Should have got that skill. This is one of my favorite levels. Actually, you can probably just look and see what this, see a creepy little look. That's a creepy look from a snowman. First thing that I recommend in this level, I believe, if I remember correctly, is get rid of the snowman. The snowman will kill you. You will end up killing you. Once throwing those snowballs. So, go find Bottles. Learn the move, and then go kill the snowman. That's it. That's all the moves that Bottles can teach you. What I recommend is aiming just a little bit above them, a little above their face. Like, if I aim should aim right here.
Oh,
that's horrible. But you aim like a little bit above them. Little bit above where you expect to hit. It's kind of hard to explain. Like, don't go for the red axe. Go a little bit above it. You'll be sure to hit them. You gotta be level, though. Because if you're not level with them, you're not gonna hit. And don't aim down at the ground, whatever you do. Try to aim like this, because even if you miss, you won't run into the ground. Let's try to hit him anyways, I guess. I guess it's all trial and error anyways. I think he's the last one. That it? Yeah, that's it. And you see that jiggy that appeared on top of the snowman? You should get that right away. It's gonna use every single flower feather that you have, but you might as well get it. Ha! Take that, fuck! You can die if you fall off with this. If you use Kazooie, you won't slide around. We can just use Banjo for this one. I don't need that. Woo! Also, you need to build up your red feathers for something else that you need to do with the snowman and the Christmas tree. Okay, let's go back up here real quick. Remembering his kid's birthday present, or his kid's presents, he's going to race on a sled. Now I need to go where all the snowmen died, so that I can get whatever they were keeping on them. Yeah, even cold water talks to you. Okay, should go over here. You can actually come in here for a free life every time you want. There's a free life behind that, the crystal. Alright, the snowman, you need to hit the buttons. Uh-oh. that Brigal Bash, or whatever you call that, when you press the B button, you can actually aim a little bit while you're doing it. You can just use the control stick to aim where you want to go. There we go. Takes care of that one. Hey, you gotta go help out the Twinklies, which are lights for the Christmas tree. I think. Unless they want the, let's see. This one used the R. If you use the R button, you can turn really fast. That turned out horrible. That's why I don't like this one. Like, it's a really strict time limit. I probably should just let that run out. I've already lost a lot of time on it. Let's move over to this wheel. Hey! Stop. Easier said than done. There we go. inside the tree.
Welcome, welcome.
Woo! Woo! Which has termites, apparently. Get the jiggy from, what's his name? Wasa the Walrus, I believe. Maybe not. Anyways, I could just go up here. Maybe.
Go up, go.
As a walrus, what are your special abilities? Survive cold water. That's pretty much it. Alright, is there anything else in the water I need? I guess it also grants you the ability to breathe underwater for some reason. First things first, let's go race Boggy. Yeah! Go!
Wahey!
Jump up the hills. Alright, let's go into Waz's place.
Oh,
course. As Banjo, you have to come in here for the gym job there. Anything else to do as the walrus? I think that's pretty much it. Getting all the notes is actually the hardest part about doing the N64 version of Banjo-Kazooie. The fact that it resets everything. Like I have shown before, I did get the ice key, and I was able to get in through here. When you enter the code into the sand castle, you're able to get past the glass and get the ice key. You'll see the ice key isn't there anymore because I have it. In Banjo-Tooie, the ice key comes down to turning Kazooie into... What was it? I think you get a Mega Globo or something, and then it turns... You can go to Wumba, and she'll turn Kazooie into a dragon. Which is actually very, very useful. Because of the fire breathing. Need to go race Boggy one last time. This one is actually kind of hard. This one is actually kind of hard. What? you fall into the water, you lose the shoes. Consequently, you lose the race. Right away. And there's a few parts where you can see I could fall into the water. That's it. That's the end of Frizzy Peak. Video here though, because it's already about 54 minutes long. So I want to thank you for watching. Feel free to leave a comment. I hope you have yourself a good day, and this is Sweet Tooth signing off. Love you.